So now, plumbing fixture and appliances. So we'll be seeing the plumbing fixture. Like I said, from the day one, I have said you two things over here. Like I've shown you the picture and I said that kid was carrying, collecting water from laboratory and WC was behind it. And I said that the both are plumbing fixture, isn't it? But what exactly in technical manner a plumbing fixture is? In short, I'll tell you, plumbing fixture is nothing but a fixture or an exchangeable device, I can say, which exchanges the water in the sense which demands water at the same time. At the same time, the water needs to drain out. Yes or no? In simple terms, I'm saying you, like example, the same thing, laboratory demands water for the cleaning of the hands or washing face and all this, right? But at the same time, the water which has drawn out of the tap, it needs to drain out, isn't it? And that is a medium. What is common in between? A fixture. Yes or no? Online. So a plumbing is an exchangeable device. It's exchanging the water, you can say, in and out device, which can be connected to a plumbing system. You know what is a plumbing system? It consists of pipe, fittings, accessories, and number of things like tanks, pumps, all this. Yes or no? So this is connected to a plumbing system to deliver and drain. That means deliver means to supply and to drain out the water. So this is a plumbing fixture. So now, very first picture, what we're going to see in the chapter number one, that is WC, in common, but in technical term, we call it a water closet. WC abbreviation is water closet. Now in this also, we do have number of variation or classifications, I can say. Like we do have first, what you are seeing is in what? Western, East, very good. Western, right? So this is Western WC, okay? Or European, you can say. Okay, so this is only WC over here. Don't keep in mind, this is something else. We'll be seeing it later on. This bowl, what you're seeing is a WC. Okay, and this WC demands cold water. Now, what is the reason we are discussing about these pictures over here? Because when we come across the designing, for example, if I'm dealing with the designing or the doing the load calculation for the pipe sizing or the routing, now one should know that what fixture demands what kind of water, like hot water or cold water. If it demands that, then as per that, I need to count the fixtures in and I need to proceed the calculation as per the needed. Okay. So this demands cold or hot online. I'm not talking about this flushing mechanism and all this. So this demands cold or hot online.
Cold.
Goes for bit.
Cold water.
Inside we'll be having a shower. So cold water. Okay. So just for the WC, not for the tank. We are not discussing. Okay. So WC also demands only cold water, always remember. Okay. So this is one European WC or Western, just now said. So the second classification is Indian or Arabic, you can say. So this is how it looks like. Again, this also demands cold water. Again, just for information, one more time, just showing you this thing so that you know that what demands what amount, what kind of water, so that we put into this and we can proceed up with a load calculation. Third is universal. This is something not common. This you can see in like public places, I can say, especially I can say in some five-star or three-star restaurants or seven-star restaurants, I mean hotels, and I can say in airports also. Why? Because this is a combination of both. If you see, this looks like European or Western, but again, it can be used as Indian or Arabic. Can you see these pedestals over here online? So it is as per the need. For example, in a restaurant or a hotel, someone came to stay, for example, a five-star or seven-star hotel. So they have this because as per their habit, one can use as per their nature of call, they can use it over here. Again, this also demands only cold water. Okay, so this was about the WCs. The next is system for the WC and urinals, flushing system, I mean to say. So this is nothing but a flush tank, I can say, but this is a gravity flush tank. And you know what is a gravity flush tank? By means of gravity, it works. And a standard flush tank, as per IPC, says that it delivers or it drains out 1.6 GPF, that is gallons per flush. You can see it over here. Can you online?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
1.6 gallons per flush. That means this tank standard has a capacity to hold off 1.6 gallons of water. That means I can say in one flush, we are draining out 1.6 liters of the water. And the water which is being used over here is not a soft water. It is recommended to use a hard water. Okay. Why? Because that water is not for use. So we can use it for the flushing purpose or cleaning of the houses. Soft water only for drinking and cooking purpose recommended. Okay. So not recommended for the flushing purpose. Okay. Now, how it works, it first of all, say the moment we press this knob, this chain lifts up and here vacuum creates, and from here the water gets into it by means of pressure. And what happens by means of gravity pressure, it comes and do the effective cleaning or the flushing in the WC. And this has been connected to only WCs, not the urinals. Don't get confused. Have anyone seen flushing tank connected with the urinal? Anyone? No, na? Yes, online. Has anyone seen? No, na?
No.
No. So this just with the WCs over here. And this how it works, I'll say you. We'll be having one knob over here. This is float valve function, you can see. But before that, this is float valve. Yes or no? And you can see this is going down. The moment it's going down, it opens from over here. You can't see because I'm showing you the cross section right now. It opens from it and this would be connected directly to one pipe from where the water gets entered and falls into this. And the moment the water has been filling, the ball or this float valve, it lifts up and it comes in like exactly this 90 degrees and it'll come in front of this. So that it'll cut the water supply or water entering into this tank like this. Can you see this? He is pressing this and you can see a gap. When this completely lifted like 90 degrees, this piston kind of thing, it will come and stick to it. So there will be no water supply from here. The moment it goes down, this will be completely open. This, can you see this online?
Yes, sir.
Right? Yes, sir.
So this is how a float valve functions. Okay. So this is the main mechanism over here. And this holds up 1.6 gallons. And the moment we press this knob, the water gets over here. And it has effective cleaning in the WC. Always remember, gravity flush tank or the flush tanks connected with the WCs, not with the urinals. Urinals, we are having something else. We'll be seeing this. So this is a first and very common. What we see in our houses is also nothing but a gravity flush tank, which delivers 1.6 gallons per flush or 1.6 GPM. Now, this is one more flush tank, but this flush tank is different from this previous flush tank. So this is flushometer.
Sir, what is the function of this fill tube? Yes, yes. Can you just please go to the previous picture?
Yes. Here,
this WC tank.
This is actually not exactly gravity flush tank. We don't have this much of things. This fill tube and all this. Here, we'll be seeing this. In this, the same mechanism over there, but some more extra thing. In this, if I say you, okay, I'll just show you. Wait just a minute. Anyone came across this tank? I mean, flushometer tank? Anyone has any idea how it works? Yes, anyone? No? Yes.
Sir, it is a refilling valve and a ball that can close and open the water supply. And one valve, which can, when we turn the flush on, the water is go to the flush and that automatically with time it's off. And then tank can go for the refill.
Okay. Not exactly. I'll say you, ye dekhiye image. See this image, everyone. This is a flushometer tank. Okay. This has the same capacity of 1.6 gallons per flush. It holds the same amount of the water. But here, inside, if you see this, this is called as air accumulator. And this is again connected. This one knob has been connected to this air accumulator. This is actually a piston, which is filling with air, compressed air inside. Okay. And here is the water supply inside into it. The moment you press this knob, this will be not acting on this lever and this lifts up and releases the pressure over here and water. So here what happens is both the things, water and air, both comes out and this will be very effective when compared with the normal gravity flush tank. So this is the most, the difference between this both tanks over here. This can also be used and this is using right now because just to effective cleaning, not wastage of the water again and again. And one more thing I can say, this is expensive when compared with the gravity flush tank, okay, because of this system over here, okay, and yeah, that's the same, okay. So this is flushometer tank, always remember, okay. Flushometer tank is also a same kind of tank used for what? The flushing purpose. Inside you have is air accumulator or piston, someone says, that releases air. And so air and water at the same time, so more effective cleaning. Okay, so now this is something what we going to use with the urinal. What is this called as online?
Flushometer valve.
Very good. Flushometer valve, right, or flush valve. So now this would be again connected to the urinals. And you know this, the moment we press this lever and all this or handle, we'll be getting this. We in this also video of number of things over here, like manual and automatic, right, not just manual. So you can press this and you'll be getting a certain amount of water for once we are done with the urinal. We need to press this because this is manual and it releases some amount of the water unless and until we close it off for the flushing of the liquid over there, okay, in the urinal. So always remember WC or tanks, WC with tanks and urinal with the valves, okay. But one more thing, nowadays we are having flushometer valves connected to WCs, but not flushometer tank, flushometer valve I said. Only this kind of, only this knob you'll be seeing, and that is what? Concealed. Yes or no, Tarun, dealing with it or no?
Yes, sir. Anyone?
Omer, I think you know this, right?
Yes, sir. I work in two projects.
That's what? Flushometer valve, I'm saying. Are you aware or no? WCs. That is more effective and very huge amount of water. Anyone has any idea? Anyone on site? Good plumbing, anyone with me? The site engineer? No one?
I am roughman.
You are working, Mr. Omer, as a site engineer?
Yes, sir. I am working as a mechanical roughman.
Okay, khalas, no problem. Okay. So I think, but you have an idea because you have seen in the drawings, I guess, flushometer valve, right? And the detailing. So flushometer valve, I'll show you. If you want, I have some catalogs also, I can show you that. So, but very most important thing, point to be noted, you should note this. There's a huge difference between flushometer tank and a flushometer valve or a tank or a valve. Valve has 3 times more amount of water extracted and drained out for the cleaning purpose. But you can't compare this valve with that flushometer valve. This valve is only for urinal. Now, you don't get confused that this valve is which is connected to the urinal, which is having a low velocity and a low GPM, okay, or a less GPM. And there, the valve which has been installed with the WC, it's having a very huge amount of water drawn at the same time, okay, and it is a very huge velocity, almost 3 times of the water required of the normal gravity flush tank, that is 1.6, for example, we know that it demands 1.6 gallons of the water it drains out, right? Almost 3 means I can say how much? 4.8. Yes or no, online?
4.8.
Right. So make sure when you are seeing flush valve with the WC, it's not this valve what you are seeing with the urinal. This is designed on a low velocity system. That is designed on a very huge velocity system or with a very huge amount of the water over there. Okay. Because of the added in that. Okay. So this is the flush valve and that is also a flush valve. Don't get confused, but this is with the urinal. But if you are seeing any flush only a valve just to press in the WCs, that is what, again, just don't compare with this and that. So what is the main thing I'm trying to say here is that when you're dealing with any kind of designing, you need to know everyone that what is the flushing mechanism in the project. For example, we need to know that the flushing mechanism in our project is by flush tank or flush valve. If it's flush valve, you need to be very, very, very careful because it demands 3 times of more water. For example, I have not checked this and I have just moved on with the calculation by considering or without seeing or without getting the information from the main contractor and I have done as per the tank, then it would be wrong because I have done a big blunder because it was 1.6 I have done. It's not actually 1.6. It draws very big amount of water over there. And that has been directly connected to the water supply of the pipe in which water is always available. Okay, but here, this tanks act as a reservoir, like holding of water and then flushing, isn't it? But they're directly connected to the pipeline, following online. So just please make this in your mind, note it down. Because we will be first thing is in the designing load calculation of the pipe, we'll be checking the first thing is this, that what kind of flushing mechanism, flush tank or flush valve? Flush tank, this values, flush valve, that values. Please online, note it down, we'll be inshallah seeing that. Okay. So as I said, now this is a flush valve which has been directly connected with the WCs. You can see here is the main pipe, or the water supply pipe will be connected. Here you will be having this cross-sectional area, you will be having a kind of knob over here or here. The moment you push this, it will release a huge amount of water for the cleaning of the WC. You can see the plunger or the spring over here, which adjusts this over here. Okay, so this is one more flush valve connected with the WCs. And this is a flush valve connected with the urinals. Okay, next picture of the plumbing is nothing but a laboratory. Okay, so laboratory demands what online? Cold water or hot water?
Both.
Yes. So always remember, whenever we are dealing with a laboratory or we have come across the laboratory, I need to design this laboratory or I need to do the calculation of laboratory on the two things. That means this will be demanding cold water as well as the hot water. Yes, please.
Sir, yes, please. Regarding this flushometer valve in the WWC, where the water will store? Where do we have the storage tank?
Okay.
Storage tank.
As if now, I'll come to that. As if now, just remember, directly connected to the pipeline. and demands only called, okay, for the flushing only called. Why I'm saying it? Because we are starting from the basics, inshallah, as we move on slowly, slowly, we'll be coming to the systems also, okay, Fahad.
Got it. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Welcome. So this is laboratory, everyone. So one more picture. So laboratory demands cold and hot water, both. Okay. So this needs to be calculated or designed on the basis of that. It demands both hot and cold water. Okay. So this is a laboratory, nothing but a wash basin. This is single. And this is one more laboratory. This can be installed anywhere, but this can be installed in the living area. For example, if it's a hall or something, or where people is eye contact to this, like example in a hall and all this, then same laboratory, but here is with the pedestal. This is called as pedestal. This one, what you're seeing, a kind of leg. Here it's open, so it does not gives you that pleasant look. So that's why this is one more laboratory with this piece that is called as laboratory with pedestal. Like example in the parking area, or you can say if you're having some kind of garden or lawn where we sit, and it gives a pleasant look. Or like example in the villa or the project, we are having a hall, and inside by they're having one laboratory. So it's recommended to have this kind of thing for just for a interior purpose, in short. Okay, but this also demands what? Cold and hot. All the laboratories demand both. Yes or no? One more is what? This is called as laboratory tray. Now, what is laboratory tray? Laboratory is laboratory, demands both cold and hot. Laboratory tray is something in which multiple people can be served. Like example, I can say you in function halls, like number of people will be served, or in shopping malls and these kinds of things. Like number of people can be served. Yes or no? At the same time, online. Yes, number of tabs. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Laboratory tray. This next is again a bathtub. So what does this demands? Complete hot or complete cold or cold plus hot?
Yes, sir.
Both. Right. So this is a normal bathtub. What you're seeing, one more picture, which demands cold and hot. Okay. So next is under this, we have one more category. This is called as whirlpool bathtub. And this, what you're seeing, is called as a pressure points. From where a jet of water comes a jet of water comes and hits to the body, and it acts as a massager also. This you can see in the sauna centers, gyms and all this. Okay. And you can see there is one control panel over here from where you can increase or decrease the velocity or the intensity of the water. I mean, the cold or hot, how much you need as per your convenience, or jet of the water and all this. Okay. So this is whirlpool bathtub or jacuzzi, you can say. Again, this also demands what? Cold or hot or both?
Hot and cold.
Both.
Very good.
Both.
Right. So this is one more picture. Next is in shower. This is called as head shower because it's installed above the head over here. And this is wall mounted. You can say this is fixed. I mean, only this can be slightly tilt. Yes or no? So this is shower, and this would be generally installed at a height of 6 to 7 feet as per the region, because as per the person's personality over there, okay, in that specific region. So this is head shower over here, and this demands also cold and hot because it's just used to have a shower or a head bath. So this demands again cold and hot water by means of a mixer over here below. Next is, this is hand shower. I can say this one, you have some flexibility. You can see there's one hose pipe connected to this shower. Yes or no? Online. So that means it has some what clearance on the left, right, above and back side. Yes or no? But yes, I'm not showing you this shower. I'm trying to show you here is the laboratory tray. This is called as laboratory tray. For example, this is actually a bathroom over here. Or this can be a hall also, or a big bathroom. So now you can see this is the glass partition over here and here and here. This is completely glass. You can't see it over here. That's why with the image, when it's taken from over here, you can see it's a glass over here. And this, if you see, it is having a slight slope over here. This is laboratory tray. Okay, when the water is being drained out after bathing, the water goes in this direction and drains out this from this drain. Okay, we'll be seeing this. But here is laboratory tray, and this is one hand shower, I can say. Okay, so two things over here. And next is what? Bidet. And one more thing, I think you are getting one new concept or one new thing. I don't know anyone is aware or no. One is I'm seeing right now is rain shower. Anyone has heard about that rain shower? Anyone?
No, sir.
Google it. Rain shower, nowadays they are using it. Now, there is having a huge amount of water into that. And the panel of that would be almost, I can say, 6 to 8 inches, this big, width and length. And that would be, when you stand under that, you feel that you are under rain. Getting my point? It's a rain shower. Same thing, but again, that shower remains shower, whatever it is. Okay. But there is one thing. What? The GPM will be
increased. GPM increase.
Yes or no? Right. So Q increases over there. So change in queue. Okay, remember that. Now this is a bidet. Now what is bidet online? I think just now you said, Umair, you know this. This is right beside the WC. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Hmm. And this is bidet. Bidet is again also called as a baby cleaning. Yes or no? Used for high-class villas. And this can be used for handicapped people also. This is right beside the WC. And this is only designed for cold as per the region. But this, as per ISPC standard, this should be working on cold and hot both. That's why you can see two knobs over here. Always remember, right-hand side of us, cold. Left-hand side of us will be hot water supply. Okay. So you can see this is cold and hot, whatever it might be. And this is used for the cleaning purpose. Like example, someone is handicapped and all this. When they are done with the WC and all this, they can sit and you can see a shower, a jet of shower, sprinkles it and cleaning would be done. And from here, again, some amount of water so that what happens, this would be flushed off from over here as a kind of drain over here, you can see. So this is in high-class villas, baby cleaning and high-class villas just for the need. And again, for the handicapped people, this would be seen. Okay. And always remember, be very careful when you're dealing with this. And you need to, first of all, take permission that if they're saying it's going to be with hot and cold, just have that in writing. Because if it's only cold, you have given hot and cold. If something goes wrong, then it will be a problem for us, right? Then they'll be questioning us, then why you have done this. Okay. So very careful. Like in European countries, it is recommended because as per IPC, I can show you we are having two values, hot and cold. So it makes sense that it can be working for hot, it can be working for a cold. Yes or no, Umair?
Yes, sir.
Umair, think, because you have done this, because Umair is a draftman, he is much aware of this, I hope.
Yes, we also have in current project.
What do you have?
In our current project, we will install this.
What kind of project is that where you have installed?
This high-rise building, sir.
No, application, residential or what was that? Municipal project?
No, hotel. Mahesan Hotel, sir.
Hotel, okay. That's what. It can be used in hotels.
50 floor.
No problem. Or it might be a VIP room, something over there.
That's VIP room. Mm.